Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. These are the days of the week.
Your son likes these stickers.
They're penance, Mojo, not stickers. He used to hang them on his bedroom walls when he was just a little boy.
Is he still a little boy?
No, he's all grown up now. And I can't believe my son is finally coming home after all these years. I can't believe they found him.
What did he have again?
Amnesty? Amnesia. It's when you forget who you are.
I sometimes forget who I am.
Well, you shouldn't. You're my maid. And my very dear friend. I don't know where I'd be without you around. You comfort me when I need comforting. You lift my spirits when they need lifting. And you give me insight into things I sometimes can't see for myself.
Do you want to play marbles?
Why don't you take the rest of the day off, Mojo? I think I'm getting a migraine. And I really can't afford one right now. I want to be at my best when my son, my long-lost son, returns after 20 years.
Mrs. McKay?
Yes, Mojo?
When your son comes home, will you like him more than you like me?
He is my son.
Am I your son?
Mojo, don't you have something to clean?
I'll wash something.
Good.
Thank you, Mrs. McKay. Mrs. McKay, you better relax. You keep getting up and you go over there and then you come back here and then you sit down and then you go up there again and then you come back here and then you sit down. Then you go up there and you stand up there for a while and then you come back down here and you sit down.
Yes, Mojo, you're right.
Then you get back up again and you go over there and then you go over there and you come back down here and you sit down again and then
you... Mojo, I get the point. It's just that my son Billy will be here any minute. And I'm nervous, that's all.
Mrs. McKay, do you know what I do when I get nervous?
What? Mojo, when Billy does arrive, will you leave us alone for a while? So we can talk?
Why?
It might be awkward for Billy. And for me.
And for me?
Yes, for you. The last time I saw him, I'll never forget. He was no bigger than...
this cup?
No, he was a little bigger than that. But his little head was just a mass of golden locks. And his skin was so fair. He looked just like the Prince of England. Oh, that's him.
I'll get the door, Mrs. McKay.
Mom!
I'm sorry, you must have the wrong apartment.
Mojo!
Mom! You remember me? I'm your son, Billy McKay, your boy. look, the place is just the way I remembered it. Look at that. And there's the couch, the old couch. It's just the way I remembered it. And a window. I used to look out that thing. Look, hey, there's the chair. I remember this. I used to play behind here. Bam, bam, you're dead, I got you. Yeah, this is the old place. I remember it.
Billy, you never lived in this apartment. I moved here after you moved away.
Well, look, I've been gone a long time, you know. I can't remember everything. Give me a break.
Mrs. McKay, he doesn't look like a prince anymore.
Who's a skag? Is that sis?
No, son. You don't have a sister. This is Mojo, my maid.
Oh, yeah. Wainwright said you had a maid.
Who?
Oh, you... Look, I gotta get used to the place again, you know? Find out where you keep things, where everything is. You know, where the bedroom is. Yeah, the closet. Find out where you keep the... rat poison.
This gun under that soft thing at the front of Billy's bed, Mrs. McKay.
The pillow?
Yeah, the pillow.
Billy, where did you get that gun?
Look, it was a gift. Someone gave it to me for Columbus Day. It was a Columbus Day gift.
Why did you ask him why he carries this gun, Mrs. McKay?
Why would you bring that gun into my home, Billy?
Look, I told you, I've spent a lot of time outdoors, you know, and I duck hunt with that thing. I hunt a lot of ducks with that.
You're lying.
Look, you're starting to bug me.
That is enough, both of you. Billy, I want the truth.
I should have taken the time to have that suit properly fitted.
Nah, don't worry about it. It's fine. It's good to show a little cuff. What's bugging the dog?
Mojo, what is it?
They always cry at weddings, Mrs. McKay. I don't know what it is. I suppose it's the bride and the groom and the ushers. And the pews. And the organ.
Mojo, I don't believe the wedding started yet.
I suppose I can wait.
Friends of the bride or groom.
That's for us to know and you to find out.
Billy! Friends of the groom.
Gathered here to unite this man and this woman.
I'm sorry I'm late, but nobody bothered to tell me where the church was.
I never miss a wedding shoot, even if I'm not invited, because I just love weddings. Did the best man bring the ring today? Okay, who's the bride? Oh, she's gorgeous. And the groom is, too.
Look out! He's got a Mrs. McKay, is that you? Except what charges? I don't know. Mrs. McKay usually does that. Mrs. McKay, is that you? I can hear you screaming. Except what charges, Mrs. McKay? Mrs. McKay, you're going to have to stop screaming. I can't hear the operator. What? Yes. I accept the charges. Mrs. McKay, I can hear you now. Are you still in New York? Uh-huh. Did you see the Empire State Building? Who? Oh, he's not here right now, Mrs. McKay, but I'll tell Billy you called. Mrs. McKay, you know what? I think he's real cute. I like him a lot, Mrs. McKay. Just what? Just do my work? Okay, I will, Mrs. McKay. And don't worry, I'll take good care of him. No, I won't bother him. Okay, bye, Mrs. McKay. Mrs. McKay, he's here now. Billy's here now.
Is that my mom?
I think she just hung up. Can I fix you some lunch, Billy? Have you had lunch yet, Billy?
Is she still in New York?
Uh-huh. And I accepted the charges.
Good. Boy, you've had a day, huh? I've been all over town looking for a job. Think I can find one? Damn this recession. Mojo, don't you have something you should be doing?
Recession. Thank you very much. I'd love to dance. Could this be love? Could the flames of passion burn in you as they do in me? Oh, love me forever, Billy McKay. Billy's not here right now. He's out looking for a job in the damn recession.
Oh, I see Billy's expecting company.
Oh, I hadn't noticed. I suppose he is.
A young lady, I trust.
I trust it is.
I told Billy's mother I'd drop in on him from time to time. Wild duck. My, what bizarre taste in wine.
All right, Mrs. Halsey. Well, I'll tell Billy that you dropped in on him.
For heaven's sake, let's get some light in here. I can't see my hand in front of my face. Oh, my. I hope Violet knows Billy's using her finest china for this little soiree.
Oh, Mrs. Halsey, don't tell. Don't tell Mrs. McKay!
Mojo, what do you think I am? A blabbermouth? Speaking of which, you heard Mae Madlock attempted suicide again. Poor thing. She was drinking like a fish the last time I was over.
Well, I have to be leaving now, Mrs. Halsey. I have to lock up now, so I guess you'll have to go.
Of course, dear. You heading home?
Yes, I am, Mrs. Halsey. So I guess you'll have to go.
I'll drive you home.
You don't have to do that, Mrs. Halsey.
Nonsense. I'm driving across town anyway. Come along.
Morning, Mojo. What's that smell?
Could it be love?
Well, whatever it is, we gotta get it out of here. What time is it?
It's the afternoon.
Boy, what a night I had last night.
Did you go out with a girl?
You could say that. I picked her up at a bar. We went back to her place. What a knockout. Are you going out someplace?
I'm going out with a boy.
Good.
I go out with lots of them.
Good for you.
Lots and lots of them.
Great.
Lots of boys and lots of dates.
Really great.
But if you want to take me out, I can cancel all the others.
Oh, you don't have to do that, Mojo. And besides, I'm really kind of busy now, you know, what with looking for a job and everything. Oh, let me just get that right here. Hello? Oh, hello there. Well, I had a great time last night, too. And I didn't even get your name.
Who is that? Is that the knockout?
Hold on one second, please. Mojo, I am having a conversation with someone.
The knockout.
Mojo. Sandra, what a sexy, sexy name. Well, when can I see you again? Tonight would be great, yeah. Your place is out. You could come here. You know, my mom's still in New York. We'd have the whole place to ourselves. Great, well, yeah, okay, let me get a pen and then I'll get your number down, okay? Just hang on one second.
Hello? Mojo. I'm his sister. I'm 29. I live here and I have a disease. Hello?
Mojo! Hello? You shouldn't have done that, Mojo.
Well, what's done is done. Can I fix you something to eat, Billy?
No. You can pack your things. I'm afraid your employment here is terminated.
Is that good?
It means you're fired. I hope you understand why I have to do this, Mojo. I hope you understand why I have to fire you. You do understand, don't you?
No.
Because you interfered in my personal affairs, and that's not what you're paid to do. Do you understand?
No.
Mojo, I know that you've worked here for a long time. I know that you've worked for my mother for many, many years, and this is very difficult for me. I just know that if this had happened to my mother, she would be doing the exact same thing that I'm doing right now. And I think you know that too, don't you?
No.
Well, she would.
No, she wouldn't.
Yes, she would.
I don't think she would.
Well, I'm not going to argue with you. I think she would. I think I'm being very fair about this. I've given you a good recommendation and 2 months' salary, and I just don't feel that I have any other options. Do you?
Yes, I think there is some other options.
I'll drive you home, okay?
Billy? Yes, this means both of us are looking for a job in this damn recession, huh?
Right.
Going somewhere, pretty boy?
You again!
How'd you get out of prison?
How'd you get out of prison? How'd you get out of prison?
I escaped, that's how. I'll get back in there.
Because the party is just starting.
These are the days of the week. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. These are the days of the week.
You're a tough guy? Just because you're holding a gun? That doesn't make you tough, Rocco.
Well, yeah? Well, what does that make me, pretty boy?
It makes you a coward.
That doesn't make any sense.
Oh, don't make him mad, Billy.
Why not? What's he gonna do? Is he gonna kill both of us right here in broad daylight? What will that prove?
It'll prove I'm not a coward, for one thing.
Why'd you come here, Rocco?
Because I needed a place to crash. Sorry to inconvenience you.
Look, I'm on the lam from prison, see, and I need a place to stay, and this place is as good as any. Now, you got any rope in here?
What kind of rope?
Rope, the kind you tie people up with.
In the closet.
Good.
Behind a big jar of wax.
Thanks. All right, hold on just a minute. Get back here, both of you. Come on. What do you two take me for, stupid? This wasn't behind a wax. It was behind some bleach. All right, now, both of you. Come on, you sit down there. You get that chair, sit down. Come on, hurry up, snap to. Hold this. Hold it good and tight. Steady that sucker. Steady it good.
Oh, Rocco, I shouldn't even be here, Mr. Rocco. I was fired.
She's right, Rocco. She shouldn't be here. Yeah? She has nothing to do with this.
Well, neither do you. But you're still here, aren't you?
You'll never get away with this, Rocco. Whatever it is you're trying to get away with.
Oh. You know something? You're pretty mouthy for a guy with basically no personality, you know that? I think I'm gonna let you have it right now.
Oh, no, please, Mr. Rocco, don't let Billy have it. I love Billy, Mr. Rocco. Please don't kill him.
No, Joe.
Billy.
Lucky guy. Well, I'll let you two lovebirds alone here for a while.
Where are you going?
Where are you going? Where are you going? Look, do I butt in on your personal affairs? I'm gonna get going and do some things, see? But I'm gonna be back later. Don't wait up for me.
I hope I'm doing the right thing. I guess you have to be tied at gunpoint to a woman to finally realize what she means to you. Look at her. There's not one thought going through her head right now. But it doesn't matter. She loves me. And that's why I'm gonna marry her. Despite what anyone thinks, I know it's the right decision.
Congratulations, you two. I heard through the grapevine that you're engaged.
We plan to have a lot of babies. Maybe four of them.
It's not definite.
The state calls Mojo Gartner to the stand.
What if I get confused?
Well, Mojo, there's a damn good chance that's going to happen, but I'm going to be right here, and I don't want you to worry about anything.
Mojo Gartner?
Present.
Take the stand, please.
Thank you.
You solemnly swear that the testimony you are about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help you God.
What?
Do you solemnly swear that the testimony you are about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help you God?
Hi ho.
These are the days of the week.